She's a perfect coach. I mean, just to give an introduction about her, she is coaching the Indian women's cricket team. She's a strength and conditional coach. You can really see her, the strength she has. And she was also part of bringing women cricket team, strength, get that strength of women cricket team for World Cup in 2017. One of the things which we were managing all the entire 1 week, and she's so persistent that she never gave up. I mean, they were phone was giving issues, the laptop was giving issues, the headset and Bluetooth was giving issues. She almost went to the stores in this particular pandemic trying to get the laptop and issues fixed because she wanted to go live, and she never wanted to give up. I mean, that's one thing. I mean, in this particular situation, any other guest would have just given up on this particular interview and said, "Hey, Ravi, I think this is not working out. Let's do it later, or let's cancel the plan because it's not working out." She has gone to their son, tried different headsets. We've realized the app which I'm using, I was using, was having. So, thank you, ma'am. We'll start with a quick introduction about yourself. Maybe you can talk about yourself, and then we'll get into these rapid fire questions and also the 1 minute CM question. It's an
Okay.
honor having you here.
Thank you. Thanks for the opportunity. To say a few things about myself, I was born in Madurai, brought up in Chennai. I was in Coimbatore for some time and then moved to Chennai in 1966. And when I was about 12 years old, my school teacher thought I was I had good sprinting ability. So she invited me to get into sports. So I thought I'll give it a try. My family, everybody was an athlete at the state level. So it was natural for me to have a liking for sports, and I joined there. She actually nurtured us really well, and she brought IAS coaches then in 66, NIS from NIS Patiala. And we were given free coaching, and so I could do well in the state level, national level. I was a junior national champion twice consecutively in 68, 69, and then went into senior section, and then got into a government job on sports quota. So during my university stint, I met my husband, who's a cricket player, who was a cricket player for Tamil Nadu State, and he also played South
That's
Zone and rest of India. So there was a mutual topic to discuss about sports and fitness, and so we started liking each other, and we got married in 78. And then I continued my passion for running. Since he was in a bank job, he was getting frequently transferred. So wherever I went, I wanted to continue my fitness, and I kept running. And running was easy for me, so it just came natural. So we both used to run, whatever the conditions may be. So then when I came back to Chennai after our foreign posting and everywhere, then I met another lady, Steena Vasu, TT Vasu's wife, who is still there. She introduced group exercise into India way back in 85. So I went there to just maintain fitness, and she liked my style and my energy levels, and then she made me an instructor. There was no formal education for to become an instructor. She herself helped us to learn coaching, teaching skills. So then I became a group exercise instructor. I quit my government job because by then I had two boys, and I had to devote time for the boys. So I took 10-year break, and then I didn't go back because then we came back from abroad. The schooling was different, no? So if they were in international school, and when we came here, Hindi was level was high. We were in Delhi, we were in many places. So I had to stay home and help these children survive. So I joined Steena Vasu, and luck would have it. I mean, I was at the right place at the right time throughout my life, right from meeting a good PT teacher to a good husband to a good boss. At that time, Reebok came into India in 1995. So the CEO of Reebok was studying fitness in India, and during his flight back home from Chennai to Delhi, his next passenger was my colleague who was working with Srinath Vasu. So he said, I'm looking for a young lady or anybody who could teach group exercise. We want to introduce fitness. So Reebok is the only first company to introduce fitness into India, group exercise, way back in 95. Nice. So this man was very passionate. His name is Muktesh Pant. So my friend immediately gave my number and said, my friend is an athlete. She does very well. She's coming to Delhi on transfer. She has never been to that place. So I went to Delhi after that. So she introduced me to him and he said, okay, come and meet her. Let her meet me. So as you said in the beginning, I'll never give up. So first thing when I landed, I went straight to him. At that time, Reebok didn't even have an office. They were working out of a hotel. So he said, come and meet me at the hotel. I said, what? Come and meet at the hotel? Then I took my husband with me. And I was 45 years old at that time. Already two children. I still didn't have the courage to go meet him in. But he's a very nice gentleman, okay? So I went there with my husband and he looked at my husband. And I said, what? Do I look like a rogue or what? I am a CEO of a company and you bring your husband along with you for an interview. I said, this is Delhi. What to expect? I don't know. So I came. He was laughing away and he made a joke out of it in the office also that Radha came with her husband for an interview. So that's me. So, and he took me inside and I didn't give up. I chased him for 1 month because they didn't have an office even to start anything. But I didn't give up. That's the only lead I had in Delhi, you know. So I went after him and then he got tired of me, like how you do your job, whatever. So he said, okay, come, I'll give you a job. So he took me in and then he gave me about 100 ladies, 100 people were given training and out of that 20 were selected and I was among the 20. And then out that's nice. 20, we had a very rigorous training from a South African. So he selected me because I'm a science student and I was an athlete and I kept running. And he said, okay, you are the senior here. All the rest were 16, 20. So he said, you lead the team and you take this up for Reebok India because we are going back. So Reebok India took me in 96 and from 96 to 2015, I worked with them. So they encouraged me to study more. I went all over the India spreading group fitness and Reebok became a big brand for fitness also. And thanks to them, they sent me abroad to study further in fitness. So that's how my fitness journey started. And then I continued from group exercise. I graduated to personal training because my boss wanted me to train other big bosses. So before training, I wanted to know how to train people. You know, I've done group, but I've not done individually one-on-one. So I was a little scared. Okay. So I had to do some certifications from abroad to try and coach individuals. So then, since I was an athlete, my husband said, come and train my cricket team, IOB cricket team. So I went and trained and I got interested in sports conditioning. Then my husband got transferred to Mumbai. Then I went to Mumbai and I got under-19 women's team to coach through BCCI, through Mumbai Cricket Association. And from Mumbai, we went to Chennai on transfer. So I trained Tamil Nadu cricket team, women's cricket team, under-19 and under-23. For about 8 years, this went on. Then in between, I worked in a gym as a program director. And from there, I got a chance to attend an NCA camp by BCCI. Then they selected me. I was the only one who wrote the exam from the women's side. All men wrote. And I was the only woman who actually wrote the exam after the workshop. And I did well. So they took me with the women's cricket team for a year. And by then I turned senior citizen. So after the World Cup, we lost by 9 runs. We came up to finals. And then some age rules came and I became age bar, I couldn't continue. But then we shifted to Bangalore because my second son lives here. He works in a company. And my elder son is both passed out from IIT Madras. The elder one went to US and did his doctorate and he's working in Columbia University as a professor. And my second one is working here. He's an MBA from Calcutta IIM. So now all my job, everything is over. Then I decided to now work in a small school. In a big school where I take care of the under 17, 10 to 17 cricket boys. So now currently I also have a gym finally, and I train sportsmen, basically cricket and young boys and girls, and I just love the job. So that's a long, long story, but it's like...
that's an awesome journey, I would say.
Yeah, wonderful journey. I had nothing to complain. Because people served there without getting into a World Cup in the team. But within 1 year, I got an opportunity to go. And second time we came to finals and lost only by 9 runs. So it's okay. Maybe we'll get there next time. So that's my fitness journey.
Cool. Are you still working out?
Yeah, of course. The main thing I forgot, Ravi, I run marathons. So, because that running helped me to continue, and I had some good friends in Chennai. So, they said, why don't you go run full and half? I said, barely. I run only 5 to 10K. I said, okay, let me train. So, in 2000, I just started my long distance career. So, from then onwards, I have every age category, I'm the winner. 45, 50, 55, 60. Now, I'm past 65 category. That's okay. So, I run full and half. Started Mumbai Marathon, Airtel Delhi, and Chennai. And recently, I ran the Standard Chartered, the Tata Mumbai Marathon in January before COVID. And I registered for 10K TCS in Bangalore, but that didn't happen. Hopefully, September, I'll run the 10K. So, 10K.
So these are not those 3K, 5K runs. These are basically half marathons and full marathons, which are like 40, 50 kilometers, right?
Your voice is breaking.
Yeah, so these are full marathons you're talking about, not those 3 to 5 kilometers which we run to take selfies with family, relax, no.
No.
And you're the winner, you're the first one.
Daily run. 3 to 5 is daily run. Today morning also I ran in K. Half is 21K and full is 42. Full I ran twice in Bombay. Wonderful place. Great people to run along with, people like Milind Soman and... this fellow, Mukesh's brother, Anil Ambani. So, we all run on Marine Drive. So, I used to run along with them and think like, wow. And there was one Miss India. She's a regular runner. They all come for the half marathons. So, I used to run with great guns. Of course, they are nowhere compared to them. But the good friends. We all run on Marine Drive to Chowpatty to Siddhi Vinayak and come back.
So they might be feeling very, you know, guilty running with you because, you know, half the way you're like passing them out and, you know, running
ahead.
Yeah,
but in marathons, you know, there are guys in front of you and there are guys behind you. So don't look at the guys in front. Just look at the guys behind and say, okay, I'm ahead. So they also must be thinking there are many more behind them. So it doesn't matter who runs in front and who runs at the back. People enjoy the run. So even though some might feel bad, but they're not there to... clock a best time. People there come there just to enjoy the race, right? So I guess it's okay if we go past them. They'll just say hi, auntie, and this and that. I just ignore them and run.
So how
did fun?
Yeah. So how did this journey of school and then managing you've been managing women all the time. So how is it different now, managing a group, teenagers to, kids now? Where do you see the enthusiasm, there or here?
Here, with the boys, cutie boys. First thing, they are fun to work with. They are, the 10-year-olds are really, really, they keep talking, they don't want to work. But when they work, I have to applaud them and say, oh, you are the best here, Kutti boys, so fun. And senior boys are very serious. I learned a lot. They listen well. And I can make a correction and see the difference. The elite athletes, they have already reached a great level. What big difference I can make? Very tiny difference, right? And we don't get much time. Even though for World Cup, I got a lot of time. Otherwise, the camp is not so big. They all work on their own and they have reached a great level. They listen to you. They know what their body can do. So there's no challenge for me much, and I can't change much at that time. But here in small children, right from posture to running biomechanics to a lot of things we can work on, work with their parents, and it's a lot of fun. I find this more encouraging and rewarding than training senior athletes.
Yeah, Srini's have that perception saying that this I know. So, you know, I'm just doing, you know, she's just making me repeat this or, you know, making me aware. Yeah, that overconfidence that I know everything.
Yeah, the kutis are different. Kutis are different. When they see a small change, they love it. They really treat you like a queen and they listen to you. I'm like a mother or grandmother to them, most of them. But we still have fun. We pull each other's leg and we run together. We play together. And it's a lot of fun working with kutis.
So you call them kutis?
Yeah. I call all the kutis boys first, all the big senior boys. I call them kutis and they love it.
Okay. Ma'am, we want to really know you well. So I have some rapid fire questions.
Sure.
So are you ready for it?
Yep.
Yeah. So when you met your husband and, you know, he was more of your colleague and this thing. So what percentage of conversations were sports related and what conversations were inclined, you know, towards personal stuff?
Most of the conversations were sports related initially. And it's a long time. Half the things I forgot, I guess. I have to ask him what was that we were talking about. I guess it's mostly about our career and stuff like that. What we want.
So both were very serious or, you know, both? I mean, who's the naughtiest out of both?
Me.
You.
Very talkative. He doesn't talk. He'll only listen because he says if both of us talk, who is going to listen? So he listens, he doesn't talk much, and I'm the one non-stop.
Nice. So how was your childhood? And, you know, especially when you got into sports, we generally have this traditional family members, you know, this girl keeps running like this and all that, she'll not get married. So what were the things, you weird things you had to hear from your family and might not be from parents, but relatives?
I told you, right? My family is always supportive. Yeah, my mother always comes for the races. She'll bring Thair Sadam with her and curd rice with me for it to help me. So my sisters, all of us were into sports. So there was nothing against sports. In college, of course, my friends, all my friends, none of them did sports.
Mm.
Okay. So they feel strange, like I'm the first one to run to the ground as soon as the session is over. But they'll never come to the ground, never. But I had all good friends, zero interest in sports. Even now, my friendship still continues, but none of them were interested in sports. So I never gave up. So I simply go for my run. But at the rest of the time, I yap with them and chat with them. So I never had any unusual events or anything. But I still don't know. We are from a very conservative Brahmin family way back in 60s, 70s, running with shorts and going around all that. I don't know whether people felt bad or those days, I don't think there was ragging and teasing so much. So it was not that bad. And I never cared for anything. So for me, there was no issues with being in sports.
Family.
Yeah, no, nothing from family, nothing from friends or people around me. I think they all liked me. Even when I run in the beach or everywhere, people like it and they join me. Nobody was making fun or, you know, wondering why this lady is running like this. But now I think, even out those days, I don't think I had any bad memories of that place.
Cool. That's nice. But how are you at school? You know, those childhood days, what are the memories that recollect when you go to the fifth standard or, you know, seventh standard? So what are the real memories which are missing?
Real memories are, I used to take part in dramas, competitions and skits and all that. So when I was very small, I think I was 5, I was an angel, okay? There was a Jesus Christ's birth happening and I was an angel. But the Raja, the king didn't turn up on that day for the program.
Okay.
So the teacher said, you do double role, you be a king here and then you go change your dress and come as an angel. I said, okay. So I acted like the king with a big bush, okay? Then, when I had to come back as an angel, I forgot to remove the mush. So, I'm on the stage with all white feathers everywhere and big mush on the edge. Everybody's laughing on the front row. And I don't know why they were laughing. Then I said, what's wrong with me? Have I forgotten any words, sentences, nothing? Then somebody said, this. Then I realized the angels are coming first time with a big mush. So that was really funny. I felt really bad because nobody noticed around me. The teacher, nobody noticed. And I was very small even to think about all that, because the next scene I had to run.
You have to change your dress. So your focus was more
from
on the dress.
King to an angel is not easy. That I'll never forget in my life. And that there was another incident which is very sad. My eyesight is not very good, even though now I have got lens stitched and all. I have power, short sight from childhood. So in the university, inter-university finals, we are running 4x100 meters relay. And our team is the best team. We would have easily won gold, hands down. I'm always run the third lap. Third baton, which is the curve running. And that day, the events got delayed and it became a little dark in the night. And you have a 20-meter stagger to exchange the batons. You have to exchange within that. Beyond that, you are disqualified. So I am waiting for my baton and this girl is running fast and coming. When so many people run in the night, no? Night time, my eyesight wasn't so good. I wear glasses at. So I mistook another girl, some other university girl as my girl, and I started running without the girl
even
reached me. And I crossed the, when I went near the stagger line, the 20th line, which is a red mark, then I realized I haven't got my baton and my zone is over. And when I turned, that girl is crying, running, Radha, Radha, wait, and we're here, I am already across the line, and I lost the baton. I didn't get it. I had to come to a complete stop to collect the baton, and all the teams went changed. Then I collected and ran the 300 meters alone there, everybody laughing. The entire, all the other five teams have gone to the fourth zone, baton. And my girl is waiting there, my best friend. And I'm here running alone with all my speed, everything alone, because the entire zone is gone. And they're entire university, Madras University, lost the gold because I ran ahead of the baton zone. So that's one I'll never forget. That's a very sad thing. Because of me, others also didn't get a medal. But from then onwards, I don't run in the night. I don't run in the evening. I'm very scared.
Okay.
That one incident. I run only in the mornings or evenings.
Those are exciting, weird memories.
I don't know.
So were you studious or were you notorious during your school days? Very studious.
Yeah, I did chemistry, BSc chemistry with physics as ancillary. And
during the stage shows and drama. Yeah, please go ahead.
What?
No, you were saying something. Please go ahead.
Yeah. So in the college days also, I used to participate in dramatics, everything. And it was fun. I don't give up. All activities I go sign up. I can't sing. That's one thing I can't do. Don't ask me to sing. But the rest of the things, anything other than that, I can paint, I can draw. I like dramas, all that. My children are also into all that. They also run. And they run with me. Sometimes the second one who is here, he runs half marathons with me. We run 10Ks together in the competitions. So it's fun. Nice, nice to run with your own son, you know, in the same race. True. Keep talking and we enjoy running together.
So what is that one thing which you use? That, you know, everybody has got a word. Like, you know, that's a frequently used word when you are... punishing somebody or scolding somebody, you know, while somebody, you know, you're training, right? You're coaching. So now kids, but then women. So what was your frequently used word? How does Radha behave when, you know, she is coaching and somebody is not doing things?
No, I don't scold anybody.
You don't scold.
No, that doesn't work. I don't.
So what's your mantra? How do you ensure that they are doing what they're supposed to do?
Yeah. So, if someone is even in the elite level, Julian, all of them, they listen very well. They like when you give them some corrections. They love to do it, even though they are all very senior and have conquered. But they are very, very nice about when we tell them this is what it should be. So I used to tell them when I see them doing something wrong or if I think that they need correction, I tell them, watch me. Now I'm going to show you and this may help you better than what you do. You give it a try and then tell me. So they give a try and then they say, yeah, we think this is better. So I think showing and being a leader there and pyar se bolne se, I think you can get work done rather than scolding. Scolding doesn't work, especially with kids now. There's no way to scold. I tell them, auntie is going to do with you, now you show me. So I do with them and then they laugh and they try to copy. So if you tell them they don't like it, especially in front of other children, they don't like to be scolded. They don't like to be picked up immediately for any mistake. Generally, I give a general comment. Please keep your back straight or look straight. Don't look down without naming anybody. And they know whoever is looking down that I'm referring to them. So generally, cueing will help. No scolding.
Okay. So though during I come school days,
very strict, I'm not strict.
Okay. So vice versa, when you were in school days, you know, when was that you got scoldings, proper scoldings, which you still remember?
No. I'm very obedient at that. I'll do anything and everything if the teacher asks me to do. I'm never late. Never late for school. Never late for practice. No scolding.
So now, when we do dramas in school and college, and you know, and you were participating, except for singing, you were participating in a lot of things. There is generally one guy like me who would join this particular drama where, though I don't know how to sing, dance, or do the drama, because you were there. So, any one guy you remember who joined this particular program because you were there, you were participating. Like in my school days, I used to participate because my girlfriend was there in that drama and I had no idea of singing. I was not singing properly. But I just joined that particular group because there was inter-college competition and all that. So do you remember any guy who did that, who joined one of your dramas or events on the stage or outside just because you were participating?
There were a lot of guys who liked my teaching or who liked the way I am. But they were not my boyfriends. They were all my students. They joined because I'm there. So if I go for a workshop, yesterday also I did a workshop. So I sent many of my students and some of them joined because I also joined that workshop. So that way, I guess I'm quite motivating for people to join. But unlike your case, I don't think they were all my boyfriends.
Not now. I'm talking about school and you know this college days.
No, I studied in a girls' school.
So oh, okay.
Then I studied in a girls'
You missed the opportunity.
I studied in girls' college, Stella Maris College, where boys are not allowed. Nobody can come. Only Loyola boys can come.
Oh. Why that?
They are brothers and sisters.
Oh, okay.
Loyola and Stella. Yeah.
Okay. So by default, they have to be brothers and sisters.
All brothers and sisters. What is after that, I don't know. But we never had any joint program with Loyola. Never. Okay. At least when I was there, those days. And I studied throughout in girls' school and girls' college. And I don't think of anybody joining from outside for that. But yes, my students all join, come for the workshop because I am there. But by then, I was already 45 and above.
Okay. Now you're most of the time in the school around the kids. What is the difference? What is that you missed between those days during, you know, the 70s, 80s schooling and the schooling now in terms of games or sports?
Facilities are much better now. We never had all this. We never had a proper ground and proper equipment. Even though the teacher tried, money was not there at that time. But now money is there. Infrastructure is really good. Logistic support, everything is there. I wish I'm young now and can take advantage of all these things available, which was not there before. So I think these kids are all very, very fortunate. And they get all access to internet and everything and good training methods. And a lot of things have improved from 70s to now. So I think these kids are very lucky. But the competition is also very heavy nowadays. Because a lot of children participate now. Earlier when we were there, there weren't many participants. So,
okay. Do you think that cricket is one sport which is like overrated, or do you feel, you know, we are good with that?
No, no, I don't think overrated. The way they work so hard, of course, every sport they work so hard. I'm not saying that. Football, tennis, every game is tough to get to that higher level. I agree with that. But the popularity that they get is not overrated. I don't think so.
Okay. And what is conditional training? I mean,
conditioning is more to do with the running capacity.
Okay.
Our,
so how much I can run without losing my breath? Is that conditional?
No. Your sprints, endurance run, all that is called conditioning. Strength and conditioning means strength is only muscular strength. Conditioning is everything to do with your aerobic fitness, anaerobic fitness, ability to run faster, ability to turn, twist, agility, all that come in conditioning.
Okay, got you.
Yeah.
Cool.
For that sport, what
I'm done with my questions. Anything specific you want to mention before we get on to the 1 minute CM question?
Yeah. I wish all girls participate in sports, in any form of sport. Yeah, because there is a lot of encouragement from the government, from the state government, and from families. So if we all did it, you all can do it. The girls can do it. So I wish all the girl children participate and bring more laurels to the country.
Cool. Now the main question, ma'am, what are the areas you would focus on to become the chief minister?
Two things I want to focus on. I've already decided. Okay. First one is open all the gyms first, quickly. As soon as I become gym, CM first, I'll open all the gyms because we are waiting to go get there. And second thing is street dogs. The street dogs are having a tough time. They don't get food, they don't have shelter, they don't have anybody to take care. I wish we could do something, so I will do something for the street dogs. Maybe pick them all up, take them to a kennel, feed them and nurse them very well of all the diseases and everything, and then let them go again, let them play around in the road, but somebody to take care of them because they are all suffering because of this COVID. We are all indoor and nobody takes care of the street dogs. These are the two areas I would like to attend to when I become a CM. Soon I become a CM.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am. We also had one of the guests, Vandana Nambiar. She also had similar plans. So I think we can do something together and, you know, have a solution for the street dogs.
Correct.
So,
yeah. True.
But thank you for taking time out. You know, it's right. So very nice having you on the show. And sorry about all the technical issues and, you know, but I really admire, you know, you're not,
Thank you so much.
We have to do it attitude. And yeah, please, you know, we will start following you. Friends, I'll also share Radha Krishna's, you know, her page and, you know, her contact details. Keep following her. She is very inspirational, you know, sportswoman person who's already coaching, and she's coached women cricket team for the World Cup, and you know, we have we really need some inspirational stories like this around us. So thank you, madam. Have a great day. Thank you for taking time out, and I wish your guests who are coming out for lunch have good time with you. So
thank you so much, Ravi. Thanks for patiently trying out all possible ways to make this happen. Sorry, we went through a lot of issues, but finally we made it. I would like to thank the audience and the Work TV also. Thank you so much. We'll keep in touch.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a great Sunday.